Hello everyone, this is Marian from UNICEF. Today we will learn how to use H5P to build an interactive book. In this lesson, you will learn what is H5P and you will learn some pros and cons of using H5P. I will also show you what components H5P has. Then I'll introduce interactive book from H5P. Lastly, I'll show you how to create interactive book step by step. Now, let's begin. So, what is H5P? H5P is a free and open source content collaboration framework based on JavaScript. H5P is an abbreviation for HTML5 package, and it aims to make it easy for everyone to create, share, and reuse interactive HTML5 content. All you need is a web browser and a website with an H5P plugin. The plugin enables you to create interactive content directly from your Agora course page, or you can import an H5P file to reuse any activities that you have created previously. Just like any other Agora components, you can set up the completion criteria and track user interactions and scores. Pros and cons. One good thing about H5P is it is free and easy to use. Also, H5P content is responsive and mobile friendly, which means that users will experience the same rich interactive content on computers, smartphones, and also on tablets. There are several disadvantages of using H5P. You cannot import your existing PowerPoint presentations to H5P. Also, H5P doesn't support right-to-left languages, for example, Urdu, Hebrew, Arabic, and many more. So, when you go to H5P website and click on Examples and Download, you will see a whole lot of options here that you can use for your course. There's interactive video, accordion, flashcards, filling the blanks, interactive book, and many more. In this lesson, we will learn about how to use H5P to build an interactive book. Interactive book allows users to put together large amounts of interactive content like interactive videos, questions, course presentations, and more on multiple pages. To start, first open your course page and click Turn Editing On. Then click Add a Component or Resource. Now scroll down and you will see H5P interactive content. Double click on that. So, to select interactive book from this list, look for interactive book. If you cannot find it, you can click here and search for what you are looking for. After finding the interactive book, click Details. Use the editor to add content. Change the title of the page as you want. Now, add content type you want on your first page. There are so many options you can choose from your drop-down list. Let me show you how to do image hotspot. Add a title of the image hotspot. I'll add a picture in the background image. Then I'll keep these options as it is. For the hotspot position, click on the thumbnail image to place the hotspot. In the pop-up content, I'm selecting text and adding text here. I'll add one more hotspot for testing. Now you can scroll up and add another page. Write a title here. I'm choosing true or false for this content type. Here, you can choose the correct answer. In the behavioral settings, you can select how you want to show the answer. Now, scroll down and click Display Options. Turn on Display Action Bar and Frame. Now, click Grade. If the activity has a score and a passing grade or score, type Grade to Pass and Maximum Grade. If you want to track the completion of the activity, click Activity Completion and select an option for completion tracking. Now, click Save and Display. That's about it. Now you can click Turn Editing Off and test it. Let me give you one tip of using interactive book. If you have a quiz in your interactive book, you will have this Summary and Submit button as default. It is unnecessary to have it if you choose the interactive book as a learning tool. We recommend you to use interactive book as a learning tool and not as an assessment tool. You can always turn it off from the behavioral settings. That's it. I hope you find this video helpful. Thanks for watching.